We know that a 2x2 matrix is invertible if and only if its determinant is non-zero. Now we know how to compute determinants of larger matrices. I know already a few properties. That means that we are now ready to show that the same rule also holds for larger matrices. And we will see that in this video. Let's start with a matrix A and suppose that A is not invertible. That means that if we do row reduction, we cannot row reduce A to the identity matrix. So A will not have, in this case, if you look at 3x3, A will have not 3 pivots. A will have less pivots, say 0 or 1 or 2. It doesn't matter how many. In the example, I took 2. But you can do the same argument if you have 1 pivot or even 0 pivots. So as long as it is not 3. So and we'll reduce A and say we have 2 pivots over here and over there. So we'll reduce it and we call the reduced matrix B. And then we observe that if we compute the determinant of B, we get number times 0. So the determinant of B equals 0. Doesn't matter what the numbers are because you multiply by 0. So A is not invertible, that means that the determinant of B equals 0. But during row reduction, the determinant changes. You can multiply with a minus sign or by a factor, non-zero. But if your determinant of 0 is 0, so you say you start with B and you go back to B and you go back to A, if you do your row reduction steps, your determinant starts 0 and you do 2 times 0 or minus 1 times 0 or 5 times 0, your determinant stays 0. So the determinant changes, but if it's 0, it remains 0. It cannot become from 0 suddenly something non-zero, because you're only multiplying by numbers. So if your determinant of B equals 0, that means that also your determinant of A was 0. So if A is not invertible, that means that your determinant of A equals 0. What happens now if A is invertible? Well, if A is invertible, then you can row reduce to the identity matrix. If it's 3x3, that means that you have 3 pivots. And we have again our matrix B. Now, we can compute the determinant of the matrix B. It's a number times a number times a number. They are pivots, so they are not 0. So that means that the determinant of B is a number which is not equal to 0. Well, during the row reduction, you changed your determinant. For example, it becomes twice larger, or it becomes minus 1 times the determinant. But again, if your determinant is not 0, say you end up with 6, you could come from 12 or from minus 6, but you could never come from 0, because you are either multiplying by minus 1 or by a number not equal to 0. So if your determinant of B is not equal to 0, that means that your determinant of A is also not equal to 0. So if A is invertible, that means that your determinant of A is not equal to 0. So we can combine that, A not invertible, that A is 0, A is invertible, that A non-zero. So if you combine those two statements, you get A is invertible if and only if the determinant of A is not equal to 0. The same as what we had for 2x2 matrices also holds for larger matrices.